A Fox News alert now on the investigation into the brutal murder of four Americans in Libya, including the U.S. ambassador, Christopher Stevens. Questions are still swirling about what really sparked the attack on the U.S. embassy in Benghazi, the consulate, I should say, and whether it was a coordinated strike timed 11 years to the day after the 9/11 terror attacks. We are learning now that a group linked to Al-Qaeda may have been behind the attack. Pete Hoekstra is a former congressman from Michigan and the Republican Senate candidate there. He's also the former chair of the House Permanent Select Committee on Intelligence. So about this attack, coming 11 years to the day since the 9/11 attacks, coming after the number two guy in Al-Qaeda, a Libyan, was killed in a U.S. drone strike, do you think this attack has anything to do whatsoever with Muslims being offended by that so-called film?
Well, John, I've had the opportunity to maintain many of the contacts that I've had in the national security and the intelligence community. And my experience as chairman of the Intel Committee tells me this movie has nothing to do with it. This is all about 9/11 and this new soft underbelly as to where America is vulnerable. You know, we're vulnerable from Afghanistan through Yemen, through Egypt, through Libya. Al-Qaeda, other radical elements have identified this vulnerability, and they chose 9/11, 2012 as the time to take advantage of it.
Yeah, the attack on the consulate started around 10 p.m. It seems to me pretty ludicrous to believe that a bunch of, you know, innocent Libyans suddenly show up at 10 p.m. armed with machine guns, rocket-propelled grenades, and I even heard anti-aircraft missiles to protest at an embassy.
Yeah, this was not a spontaneous attack. Our embassies, our consulates, and these were targets. They've been targets in the past. Go back to 1998 when we had the attack against our embassy in Kenya, Tanzania. You know, when these radicals identify a vulnerability, they've taken advantage of it. They're doing the same thing because through that arc of instability, we have governments that are either unwilling or unable to protect American interests.
Catherine Herridge reported that Ansar al-Sharia, the Libyan offshoot of Al-Qaeda, reportedly may be involved in this. What do you know about that group?
Well, I mean, you know, these groups are all popping up all over the place. They share a common ideology. They hate the West. These were the kinds of groups that Muammar Gaddafi was working with the United States to keep under control. Now that Gaddafi is gone, as evil as he was, these groups are now, you know, coming up throughout that whole area, and they're testing our defenses, and they're testing the willingness of the governments that are now in place to defend American interests. You know, we saw what happened on Tuesday. We see what's happening now through the week. The real telling tale may be tomorrow. How far will these protests spread on a Friday, which is the day of prayer for the Muslim world?
So you expect that things could get worse tomorrow?
Oh, I think over the next, tomorrow will be one sign, but over the coming weeks, I expect that America is going to be very vulnerable. Remember, what did Al-Qaeda, what did the radical groups learn on Tuesday? What are they learning right now? That the governments in this region, the government in Egypt, was unwilling, even though they would be able to, they were unwilling to protect our embassy. In Libya and Yemen, they're seeing that the governments may be trying to protect our embassies, but they are unable to protect the American embassies, our consulates, and American diplomats. So I think they're going to keep the pressure on. Tomorrow will be part, well, we may see a continuation and a growth of this pattern. Tomorrow's not the final day in this, but it will tell us whether we are on a path of growth, which I think we are going to see a growth of pressure on the U.S., or whether, you know, we've just seen 3 days of violence and it's going to diminish. I think it's going to get bigger.
We saw in Tehran 1979, you cannot put enough Marines in an embassy to guard it if the host nation is not willing to do its part. What would you do? What would you say to the governments of Egypt and Tripoli and now, I'm sorry, Egypt and Libya and now Yemen, resulting from these attacks on our diplomatic facilities there?
Well, I mean, I think, number one, we've got to protect our interests. I think you're going to see a strategic retrenchment in each of these countries, because you're absolutely right. We can't put enough Marines into these countries to protect our interests, to protect our diplomats. We saw that in Saudi Arabia with the Khobar Towers. We saw that with the USS Cole. So we're going to have a strategic retrenchment to make sure that we minimize our footprint in each of these countries. Then we need to forcefully use diplomatic pressure to, you know, to get these countries to stand up and do what they are supposed to do, which is protect foreign nationals, to protect foreign embassies within their countries. And until they prove that, we're going to have a smaller footprint in each of these countries.
Pete Hoekstra, who chaired the House Intelligence Committee for years. Thanks, Congressman.
Great. Thank you.